Once upon a time, a long time ago, there lived a man named Nimrod. Nimrod was the great-grandson of Noah. He was the most popular man on the earth at the time. Matter of fact, he was the king of the then known world. He was responsible for building the cities of Babel and the Tower of Babel and the city of Nineveh, amongst others. Nimrod married a woman named Semiramis. Now, Semiramis and Nimrod became basically king and queen of the then known world. Well, at some point, Nimrod dies, and he became deified. He was the very first person that was ever deified on planet Earth, and they made him the sun god, which ended up being Baal. And so Baal is now ruling the universe as the sun god, and somehow, luck has it, through the Babylonian legend, that Semiramis gets pregnant by the rays of the sun of her deceased husband, Nimrod. And she gives birth to a young baby boy named Tammuz. And he took the place of his father, ruling the world, and had tremendous power. But more than anything, he was a credible hunter. But unfortunately, his gift and his skill of hunting caught up with him one day because he was killed during his 40th year by a wild boar. So every year, in commemoration of celebrating the death and the deification of Tammuz, which became the son of God, the son of his father, they would set aside 40 days prior to Easter, and they would fast and they would pray, and they would have a giant feast on Easter Sunday where they would celebrate the death and the resurrection of Tammuz. And guess what they would have for dinner on that Sunday evening? You got it, Easter ham. They would kill a boar in commemoration to Tammuz, who was killed by a wild boar. And yes, the 40 days prior to Easter, we call it Lent, or the Catholics call it Lent, that 40 days did not come from, my friends, the 40 days of Jesus in the wilderness. That 40 days was already in place for thousands of years before Jesus even showed up. It comes from the 40 days of fasting and praying for Tammuz before they celebrated Easter. Semiramis, at some point after that, she died, and she was sent up into heaven, but apparently her deceased husband, Baal, was not ready for her. So he sent her back down into Earth in a giant egg, and it exploded in the Euphrates River. And the very first thing that she did when she came out of that egg was she turned a bird into an egg-laying rabbit. That's right. As crazy as it sounds, that's where we get our egg-laying rabbit from. That's where we get the Easter Bunny from. Now, before you go any further, you're thinking, well, an egg? This sounds like a fairy tale. Well, it's a Babylonian legend, but you have to understand Eastern culture back then is that eggs were a tremendous symbol of fertility among many of the gods. Every spring, the first Sunday after the vernal equinox, the spring equinox, they had what was called Ishtar's Sunday. And they would have a sunrise service. Now, this part of the legend is difficult to confirm because there's so many different versions. You can make up your own mind whether or not this particular part of the legend will be accredited to you. But it is quite interesting how one particular part of the legend lines up so eerily with dying of Easter eggs. Because what they used to do in this part of the legend was that at the sunrise service, the priest of Ishtar would impregnate young virgins on the altar. And during that same service, they would take the babies that were now 3 months old from the previous year, and they would sacrifice those children on the altar to Ishtar. And then they would take the eggs of Ishtar, and they would dip those eggs in the blood of those young infants. And that is where we get sunrise services, and that is potentially where we get the dying of Easter eggs.